Are you ready to take your programming skills to the next level? Are you eager to become a backend developer with the knowledge of one of the most popular and in-demand technology in the industry? Look no further. My comprehensive Node.js course is here to guide you on the transformative journey into the world of server-side JavaScript. This course is designed to cater beginners and experienced developers. You just need to have a prerequisite knowledge of HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. If you don't know anything, not to worry, you can always check out my free playlist here. And then my step-by-step curriculum will help you to learn Node.js and build backend projects. If you still haven't enrolled to the course, then this video will help you to decide whether this course is the right choice for you or not to start your Node.js learning journey. So if this sounds interesting, then stick around. Also, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon so that you don't miss the videos like this one. So let's get started. Alright guys, so you can visit the website using www.thepeshmalviya.com, and this is going to take us to the landing page of our website. You will see that we have the Node.js course. So you just have to click on this tile and this is going to take you to the course landing page. You will see that we have Node.js, the complete guide to build backend projects in 2023. Now let me show you some of the key highlights of this course. So what you're going to get when you purchase this course, you will have a recorded content of 10 hours and that too in a high quality videos. You will have two live sessions which will help you to clear your doubts and some discussions. The course already started from 3rd of April and we have already uploaded all the videos in the course curriculum. You will also get a certificate once you complete this course. In the end of this course, we have also uploaded some of the videos that will be bonus for you, and that will help you to understand more about JavaScript and the concepts. For this course, the prerequisite will be that you should know HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. And if you need help in the HTML, CSS, and JavaScript, you can check out my YouTube comprehensive videos on these topics. You can also learn Node.js with your self-paced and practical learning. And in the end, we have three projects which are included in this course. And you can buy this course by just click on the buy course. This course is available at a minimum price of 999, which is very low as compared to the other courses available in the market. Now let me give you the curriculum that we are going to have for this course. So this course is divided into chapters and each of the chapters has its own meaning. So let's start with the first chapter, which is getting started with Node.js. So this is the first chapter, and in this chapter we are going to cover introduction to Node.js. Then we will see how we install and we are going to explore the Node.js. We will also see how we can set up the environment variables in Node.js. After that, we are going to talk about the read, evaluate, print loop, and we will see how we do the operations on the command line. Then we will learn about the Node.js command line arguments, and then we will see how we do the IO operations on the command line. After that, we are going to have the introduction to Node Package Manager, which is the NPM tool we are going to use as a package manager to manage our dependencies in the project. Then we will understand about the file system and the path module, which are the two of the important modules Node.js offers. In the next chapter, we are going to learn about the Express. So we will have the getting started with Express. And in this, we will start with the very basic introduction of the Express, as what is Express and why it is a popular Node.js framework to build REST APIs. Then we will learn about how we install and create our first Express app. We will also understand about the routes setup in Express, so how we have different routes for our API endpoints. Then we will explore the Express app generator and we will understand what files and folder structure that is generated using the Express generator. Then we will understand about the Express middleware, what are they and what are the types of these Express middleware. We will see them in detail with application and router level middleware, error handler and built-in middleware, and the last one is the third party middleware. So after getting this basic knowledge of the Node.js and the Express, we are going to deep dive into our third chapter, which will include Node.js, Express, JWT, and MongoDB, and we are going to build a contact management backend API. So let's see what we are going to do in this. So in this contact manager backend API, we are going to have the user who can log in and register to our system, and then he can create contacts. So with this creation of the contacts, we are going to have the CRUD operation of the contacts, and we are going to store all this CRUD operation into a MongoDB database. So we are going to learn about the Mongo's schema, MongoDB setup, login and registration, about authentication and authorization, error handling, how we do the password hashing, what are JWT access token, protecting our routes, verifying the token, and only allowing the authenticated users to create the correct operations. So there's a hell lot of things that we are going to learn with this single project. Now, once you have some grasp on the Node.js, we're going to deep dive into the second project, which will be our book review application. And in this book review application, we are going to use the Node.js Express as our framework, but this time the backend will be MySQL database. So here we are going to store the data in the form of tables and not in the form of a JSON object, which we did in our MongoDB database. So in this project, we will understand about the view engines. So we are also going to have a UI where a user can list all the books. He can add a new book, and then we can have some JavaScript logic so that we can display different views. We will also understand about how to do the filtering and sorting. We will create the database tables. We will also see how we can rate the book and we can review a book. And then we'll see how we can delete the book and enhance some of our UIs. So this project is a different kind of a project which will have a user interface. So we are going to use the view engine to create our views, and we are going to have a MySQL database that is going to store all our data related to the book's review, where you can write the reviews for the book, you can rate a book, and then you can do the CRUD operations on the book. So this is also a very good project to learn. And once you have a grasp on this project, we are going to go to a more interesting topic, and that will be the Node.js microservices. So we start with the initial basic understandings of some of the concepts about the Node.js microservices. So we will start with understanding the monolithic applications. What are they, and what are the drawbacks and limitations of using such applications? We will understand why microservices is so powerful and why it is being used. Then we will also need to understand about the communication between different microservices. And the last point is, when we create microservices, what is the best approach to manage our code base? So whether we go for a mono repo or whether we go for a multi repo. So we are going to understand everything in this module. Now, once we have a grasp on the Node.js microservices, next chapter would be about creating the contact manager app, the same app which we created in our first project, but this time we are going to break it down into a microservices project, and we are going to use the Node.js Express framework, same MongoDB database, but this time the project will be based on the microservices architecture. So here we are going to create two different projects. One will be the user microservice and the other will be the contact microservices. We'll also see how we can set up a proxy API gateway so that whenever a request comes to the gateway, it will redirect it properly to one of the microservices. We are going to use the existing code base, and then we are going to transform the existing code base into an individual microservices project. So we are going to set up the environments, configs, server.js, database, and the util for user microservices. And then we will also do some cleanup, which we don't want for our user microservices. We are going to update the user model. We'll do some refactoring of the code. And then we will also have to set up some routes, because this time we are also going to add an additional functionality in our contact manager application, which will be that you can view all your contacts in your profile, and you can also add some of the contacts as your favorite contact. All right, then we are going to do the testing of all the service endpoints, and then we will just jump to our contact microservices. We are going to do very similar. We are going to write some functions, controllers for our favorite contacts, so users should be able to add and remove the favorite contact. We also need to update our model, and we are going to test all our endpoints for our contact service as well. So in this module, we are going to break down the projects, and then we are going to test the projects. We are going to clean up the code. But in the next chapter, we are actually going to see how we can communicate between these two microservices. So how a user microservice communicate with the contact microservice and complete the operation. So let's go to the next chapter, which is the microservices communication project. So it is just the extension of the project which we built in the previous chapter. So here we are going to see two different ways of communication. The first one will be the HTTP REST API, and the second one will be using message broker. So we are going to make use of a RabbitMQ. So we are going to see how we can publish the events and how we can subscribe the events. So whenever a new contact is created, a publish event is fired, and that event is subscribed in the user service so that the user service get all the relevant details that are required whenever a new contact is created. We are going to test all the APIs and endpoints with the help of the HTTP REST API communication. Once we are done with this, we are going to use the RabbitMQ service communication, which is a message broker. So there are some drawbacks which we will see about the HTTP REST API, and we will see how these drawbacks are overcome when we use a message queues, which is a RabbitMQ. Here you will see how we create the channel, and we will see how we make the connection with the message broker, and then publishing a message and subscribing a message in different services, and then testing the microservice with the message broker. So this is a very good project which is going to help you learn a lot of concepts in Node.js microservices projects, and this is going to help you to learn a lot of new concepts which is going to help you in your interviews and whenever you prepare for the job. And the last chapter is some of the bonus JavaScript videos which will be very helpful whenever you follow this course. So those videos will be the ES6 arrow function, because a lot of functions we are going to write is as an arrow function, default parameters, how to do destructuring, because destructuring also one of the important concepts that we are going to use while building different projects, higher order functions and array methods. And we will see how we can set up the yarn workspace for monorepo, and then monorepo learner project setup for React and Node.js application. And you will see that we have the Zoom session. So the Zoom session, the dates are still not announced, but you can go through all the videos and then you can start your Node.js learning journey. And I'm going to soon update the dates for the live session so that you don't miss out. So this is the complete curriculum of this course that is going to offer whenever you purchase this course. And about this course, who is this course for? If you are a student, you can take this course. If you're a working professional or a front-end developer who wants to transform themselves or aspire to become a full stack, then this is the right course for you. And why you should buy this course? Because this is a comprehensive course which will help you to become from zero to hero in Node.js, with beginner to advanced level projects. And the course have a very unique project-based approach so that you get hands-on by learning and you can build projects. And you can just click on the enroll now, and this is going to open a dialog box for you where you can fill all your details, and you can select whether you're purchasing this course from India or outside India. Based on that, the pricing will get changed, and then you can just click on buy and make the payment. So that was the complete comprehensive overview of the course and the course curriculum. So if you are spending 999 for this course, then you should have all the rights to know what you're going to get from this project and what you are going to learn from this project, whether it's beneficial for you or not. So you can decide whether to enroll it or not. So that's all I have in this video. If you like the video, a thumbs up is appreciated. You can also connect with me via Facebook or Instagram. You can follow me on Twitter for latest updates. And before you go, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon so that you don't miss the videos like this one. Thank you. Thanks for watching.